Now, every lecture I've ever given has included my tribute to my Uncle Alex, my brother's kid brother, who was a graduate of Harvard and a wise man, but just an insurance salesman in Indianapolis. He was childless. But what Uncle Alex found objectionable about so many human beings is that they so seldom noticed it when they were happy. And so we would be sitting under an apple tree, for instance, on a July afternoon, drinking lemonade and, you know, talking about this and that, and it's practically buzzy like honeybees. And Uncle Alex would stop everything and say, wait a minute, stop. If this isn't nice, I don't know what is. And so he would do that again and again, and it was very good advice, and I've taken it up. And I hope that you will take up this habit too, of noticing when things are really awfully nice and say, if this isn't nice, I don't know what is. Now then, I don't know how long have I talked, as I've lost track, as I'm supposed to speak for 45 minutes. Anybody know how long I've spoken? Huh? About 45? That's, what? All right, well, I'm going to ask for a show of hands now, so get set for that. And this is for everybody here. Everybody, no matter what age. How many of you have had a teacher at any point in your whole educational career, primary school, high school, college, grad school, how many of you have had a teacher who made you prouder to be alive, happier to be alive than you had previously believed possible? Would you show up your hands, please? Those of you who have. All right. Now then, would you please say the name of that teacher to someone sitting next to you? All done? If this isn't nice, I don't know what is. Music, please.